Hey, it's Sarah here. Thanks for joining me today. Today, I'm going to share with you how to stand out from everybody else in your network marketing company. I absolutely love network marketing. I love that I do not have to stockpile products in my garage. I love that I don't have to ship them off. I love that I don't have to keep track of all the reoccurring orders. I love that they just pay me every single month for getting other product users. But you know what I don't love? I don't love that every single person in my MLM company is selling the exact same product. I don't like that. Because why is somebody going to join my team instead of somebody else's? Why would they join my team instead of the top earner in the company? Well, there's one way to do that. There's one way to stand out from every other person in your company and in MLM, and that's to create the offer that they can't resist. Have you ever watched those late night infomercials where it's like, but wait, there's more. Not only are we gonna give you A, B, and C right now, but when you buy today, we're also gonna give you D, E, and F. Buy right now. It's the same price. Come and get it. And what do? It's like, I gotta buy it, right? I want it. I can maybe get it somewhere else, but man, look at the value that they're throwing in there, right? They don't change the price. They don't drop the price. They just increase the value, right? That's what you're going to do too. Now, you can't change the price even if you want to, right? The company sets the price, but you can increase the value. And when I say increase the value, I don't mean that you're throwing in extra stuff that costs stuff, but I mean you're increasing the value and giving them what they want. You're giving them what they need. And when you do that, they're gonna choose you every time. So for example, my friend and I were talking today and she used to work at a grocery store. And she said when she started out as the cashier, she liked it. People would just come through the line and they'd buy and they'd be off on their merry way. But she said that the company started wanting to promote products. So she said at first she was supposed to ask every single person that checked out, would you like some ice? And then that evolved into, would you like some ice or some stamps? And then it changed into, would you like some ice or some stamps or this thing that we're promoting, right? And she said when they very first started out doing that, that stemmed from when people would leave, they just were supposed to ask them, did you forget anything today? And she said that she laughed even as it was just, did you forget anything today? Because she said that when she'd go through the line and somebody would say that to her, she's like, I don't know. She's like, if I did forget something, I sure didn't remember it now. I'm going to remember when I get home. And we were laughing that what the grocery store actually needs is a way to be able to call up when you get home and realize that you don't have that item. Or if they could have that person at the door when you walk in saying, what's the one item that you came here to get today? So that when you go fill up your shopping cart and go to check out, that person can come running over and say, remember, you only came here for one thing. Did you get it? Have you guys ever done that where you go to the store for one thing and you buy everything but? I am the queen of going to Costco and forgetting to buy the ice. And sometimes that's the only thing I go for. I love their bag of ice. But you know, you walk out and you're passing by that bag of ice and it's like, there's no way in a million years that I'm waiting back in that line to get the ice, right? So what could I use? I could use someone at the cash register saying, buy the ice, buy the ice, buy the ice, right? And that's what you're going to do for your people. What's the thing that they need that's going to help them succeed either as a customer or as a team member? So right now, you might be racking your brain trying to come up with what's that perfect thing to offer them. You want to know what it is? I don't know. Would you like to know how to figure it out? You're going to go ask them. You can go ask existing customers and say, hey, what's something that would be really helpful? Maybe it's a PDF that talks about frequently asked questions. Maybe It's as simple as a video. In fact, I'll show you mine that maybe has recipes of different shakes, right? Hey, here's your protein powder. Would you like some recipes of our favorite shakes? And you're going to give it to them, right? You're just going to send that to them as a bonus when they sign up with you. Now, this does two things. It's actually pretty cool. The first thing that it does is that it ensures that they're going to pick you over the other guy that isn't offering anything, right? Have you ever seen that? It's like, sign up for my team. Good luck. You're in. Ah, great, right? And the other thing that you're going to do is that you're going to help them succeed in using your product, right? Because you're telling them, here's all the ways to use my product. Now you're going to be successful, right? You're trying to take care of those issues that might have been issues if you hadn't sent them, right? You can send somebody protein powder and they'll go, what do I do with this, right? But if you're sending protein powder and telling them different recipes that they could use with it, they're much more likely to stick with it and keep ordering the product. Same with like supplements. Are you telling them how to use it? Should they take it with food? Should they take it with water? With weight loss? Are you giving them other tips that will also help them sustain that weight loss? With skincare, are you telling them how much they should be using? Don't just assume that they're gonna go research it on their own or find it on a company website. It's just putting you a step above. Because nobody else is doing it, right? And that's what you want. And how are you going to decide what to give them? You're going to go ask them. Go ask the people that don't buy. Say, hey, is there something that if it had been here, you would have bought? What was preventing you from taking action and not doing that next step? It's kind of a scary thing to do. But here's the funny thing. Lots of times you're going to find out that they just plain forgot. And so when you remind them, it's, oh, no, I still meant to go do it. And if they don't, then they give you feedback on what they wish had been different or better, right? Maybe it's a misunderstanding. Maybe it's something that they need cleared up. And now you can address it instead of just hiding and running away. Thanks for watching today, and I'll see you soon.